All right, another Serato tip. Here we are in DJ. We have no device connected, so we get that blinking up there, so we can't play from anything but the one deck. But setup time. Now, this is completely up to you, but I'm going to give you why I do what I do. First one I do under DJ preferences, control preferences, is lock playing deck. I don't know about you, but I have tried to load a deck that's playing by mistake and rip the song off. So first thing I do is lock playing deck, which means now I can't load a track to a deck that's playing. That's fine with me. You have to stop the deck to load the deck. I'm good with that. Track end warning. I do that just in case I'm really not paying attention, but you should be paying attention. But for me, it's just a little added. Use auto gain. This is a kind of crazy one. You don't have to use it. I just find from my Scratch Live days that I set it to 92 decibels and leave it there. I'm going to do some more research on that one and just see. Now, breaking. For those of you that have wondered, you know, how should I set this up? I can do my stop time and my start time. So if you want to slow down the start time, you set it here. If you want to slow down the stop time so you get that drag, you can set it there. I personally leave these at zero. On song load. This is kind of different. Play from start or play from first cue point. I go with play from first cue point, even though I might go in and change it. Virtual deck speed, I keep at 33. Recording, I do 24-bit to wave. So that's just preference. That's, you can do 16-bit, you can do AIFF, you can do whatever you'd like. Sync preference, I do simple sync. I don't do smart sync. You can if you want, but again, this is just the way I set up my preferences. Library and display. I only keep show subcrates. I don't have iTunes library. Yeah, you know what? Hit protect library. That way you can't really mess anything up. It'll tell you if you're going to make a mistake. Maximum screen updates per second. This is something you can mess with. I keep it in the 50 to 60 range. Different people keep it at different levels. Audio. This is the big one. This is your USB buffer size for latency. The higher you have it, the less likely you're going to run into problems. The lower you have it, that's where you can get crazed. So if you put it down here, you can get into problems. I keep it at 10 milliseconds at 512. Again, this is where I've kept it. If you have another number that works for you, please put it down here and mention it, because I'm always interested in learning more about this. And then plugins are just what you have. I have the sampler, I've enabled that. Serato playlist, I enable that. Live playlist, I've got to work with a little more. And then I have video, so I can click that off. And since this doesn't have my gear plugged into it and it's not my main computer for this, it doesn't show that I have Serato video, but I do have it. So that's the way I do my setup. Please, if you have other thoughts and ideas, please let me know. I'm always interested in learning and there's always stuff I can learn. Along with, if you haven't, please subscribe. I appreciate it and thank you much.